first piece that we're playing tonight is called Fantasia for Band by Vittorio Giannini. And Giannini refers to himself as a neo-romanticist. But when it comes down to it, the only thing that makes him a neo-romanticist is that he's writing in the romantic style in the 20th century. So as with the romantic style, you're going to get beautiful, long, lush melodies, intense dynamics, and this piece that we're going to play also uses dissonance, but in a very different way. Throughout the Baroque and classical and even into the Romantic era, dissonances were added to chords to create tension, so that tension could be released later. This tension would be released by moving from a dissonant chord to a consonant chord. So in these days, the dissonances actually had function that were moving somewhere. Well, in the jazz era, composers started adding dissonances not because they had functions to move somewhere, but because they liked the sound of them. So they started adding sevenths to a lot of different chords when before sevenths were just used as a function. So now we have all of these chords that have sevenths to them, and instead of resolving, it maintains this wonderful color that after a while doesn't sound like dissonance to us anymore. So this particular piece is by the great Sammy Nesico, and it's a good timing for us to play this piece because he actually only passed away 3 months ago after a wonderful long career. And this piece also features our fine first-year saxophone player, music major, Luke. Thank you. At this time, I'd like to introduce the newly elected president of Cataract High, and attorney, Ms. Jenkins. So our next piece, we've got two more. Our next piece continues the tradition that jazz began with using dissonances as color. And we're adding to that jazz sound with a little bit of onomatopoeia. So the name of the piece is Melodious Thumb. I'm going to read a little bit from the program notes by the composer. Melodious Thumb was inspired by the famous jazz pianist Thelonious Monk. Monk's wife, Nellie Smith, nicknamed him Melodious Funk because of his clunky, awkward, and brilliant piano playing and his somewhat scatterbrained and disoriented nature. So the composer really liked the idea of playing around with Monk's name and also this whole idea of onomatopoeia, of the sounds that the words that sound like their actual sound. And so we're going to have those nice jazz dissonances in here, but we're also going to have a little bit of clumsiness. This is Melodious Thunk. Before we play our last song of the evening, there's a few things that I need to speak about. All things that make me very proud. First, hi Charlie, do you want to come over here? This is generally the time that we recognize our graduating seniors. And this year, we're not recognizing graduating seniors. We are recognizing a graduating senior. And I am actually really kind of glad that he is the only one graduating, because it allows me the opportunity to give him the recognition and speak about him in a way that he deserves. So our senior is someone you've already seen come up here. He's Justin Schaefer. And Justin has been in the band program for quite a while. And each year in the band program, he has been in the marching band, he has been in the wind ensemble, he has been in the jazz band, he has been in the jazz improv class. And in the times that I have been here, I am not aware of any time that Justin has ever missed rehearsal. As a matter of fact, I'm not aware of any time that Justin has even been late to rehearsal or had to leave early, let alone performances. Justin likes to show up early, and if it's jazz band that is the next class, he will put out his phone and he'll play jazz music and he'll help set up the room and prepare it for rehearsal. If it's concert band, he'll put out his phone, play concert music. Sometimes he likes to play movie soundtracks and help set up. Now, we haven't had to set up this year because we've been in the gym, and this has been a setup that has stayed here. But when we're usually practicing in our rehearsal hall in Wallen, several groups use that facility, so we have to set it up for every single rehearsal. And Justin would always, without being asked, show up early to do this. And we have just so many wonderful kids that have, and I shouldn't say kids, I should say young adults, that have come through this band program, that have exemplified what it is to be a Falcon and what it is to be in the Falcon Band. And I suppose when I think of Justin, I don't think of someone who is in the Falcon Band. I think of someone who is the Falcon Band. I remember the first time that I met Justin, and it was my first day on the job, and we had one tuba player. And I called Justin in my office, and I said, "Justin, I need another tuba player." And without hesitation, he said, "I love tuba!" The very first conversation we ever had, he's played tuba for us, he's played baritone for us, he's played trombone for us. And he's a special guy, and we're gonna miss him. So, we've got a special little gift here for Justin. And we don't usually do this. This is new. This is just for him. I have a little plaque here, and it says, "Falcon Band MVP." for exemplary dedication, work ethic, and attitude. Justin Schaefer, 2015-2021, signed by Greg Mosette, director of bands, Robert Hickey, former director of bands, and Neil King, director of jazz. Congratulations. So the last thing to talk about is this last piece, this last little bit of delightful dissonance. So the reason that this one has dissonance in it is for programmatic reasons. This is a programmatic piece. It is about an event. It is about a story. It is about Mount Vesuvius, the volcano that destroyed Pompeii in AD 79. So I'd like to read a little bit about this. Mount Vesuvius is an icon of power and energy in this work. This is from the composer Frank Ticelli. Originally, he had in mind a wild and passionate dance, such as might have been performed in the ancient Roman Bacchanalia. During the compositional process, he began to envision something more explosive and fiery. With its driving rhythms, exotic modes, and quotations from the Dies Irae, from the medieval Requiem Mass. So Dies Irae is from the Catholic Church, from the medieval and Baroque Catholic Mass. And you will recognize it being quoted at times in this piece. It became evident that the back dance on the final days of the doomed city of Pompeii. So we hope you enjoy Vesuvius. We hope you enjoy our concerts this year, and we'll see you next year.
you.